Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making gingerbread, and that's something that I like to make in the fall. I noticed I didn't have it in Betty's Kitchen, and I wanted to give that to you. I guess I connect it with fall because I also connect it with gingerbread men and gingerbread boys and girls and so on, and also gingerbread houses, which we have over the years made at Christmas time. I don't have anything like that in Betty's Kitchen right now. Maybe we'll need to do that over the holidays. But this is just gingerbread, and it's a nice, rich, spicy bread. And it's just comforting and warm, and you have it with a nice cup of tea and really enjoy it. So I want to show you how to make it. Start with a large mixing bowl, and into that you're going to put 1/2 cup of butter, which is softened, and you can see this is kind of melted a little bit because I put it in the microwave and got it actually a little more than softened, but that's fine. So it's a stick of butter, which is the same as 1/2 cup. Now, I'm going to use a mixer, so I'll be mixing this very quickly, and as I mix it, I'm going to gradually add 1/2 cup of granulated sugar. So you just want to beat those until you have a mixture that's light and fluffy, and you can scrape down the edges here. And then you're going to add 1 egg and beat that in. So we have 1 egg here. Just put it in and start beating. Your result will look like this. It's nice and smooth. And then you're ready to add molasses. And I did set out my jar of molasses here just so you could see it in case you're not really that familiar with molasses. This just is grandma's molasses, and it says unsulfured and also says original. So I wouldn't try to get any fancy kind or anything that has additives. In fact, the ingredients here, the only ingredient is molasses. So it doesn't even say preservatives or salt or sugar or anything like that. Of course, it's plenty sweet on its own right. And that's what gives the nice color and flavor along with the spices that we put in. I have 1 cup, so I'm just going to put that in. Push it through. And that comes out cleanly. And I am going to beat that in. Instead of just stirring, it needs to be incorporated very well. So here we go. Here's my mixture so far. Looks nice and brown, and I'm sure it's very flavorful, but we're going to add more flavor to that. To our flour, which I have sitting over here, I'm going to be adding some leavening agents, some salt, and some spices. This is 2 1/2 cups of all-purpose flour. So I'll put in my 2 cups. You don't need a very big bowl because you're just going to stir this around. Then I'll put in my 1/2 cup. And then what I have in this little dish is 1 1/2 teaspoons of baking soda and 1/2 teaspoon of salt. Just put those in. And then my spices, I have 1 teaspoon of ground cloves, that's the dark one, 1 teaspoon of ground cinnamon, that's a little bit lighter, and then 1 teaspoon of ground ginger. So those go in. Now it'll take me a minute to get this really the way I want it before I start adding it to our liquid mixture. I have my dry mixture together right here, and I don't want to just dump it all in at one time. I do have 1 cup of hot water. Now this is hot out of the tap. It's just as hot as our water comes. 1 cup is fine. And then here, what I'm going to do is add a little bit of my flavored and salted and leavened flour. A little bit goes into the mix, and we can mix that and then add the water, or we could add the water at the same time. I think I'll mix and then add water, and just continue to do that until all of our dry ingredients plus all of our water is mixed in. I have my gingerbread batter completely mixed. It's ready to go in the pan. So let me show you the pan that I'm using. This is a Pyrex dish, which actually should be 9 inches square. Mine is really only 8 inches square. You could use a metal dish or a metal pan, excuse me. It needs to be 9 inches square or somewhere close to that. For both of them, I only had 8-inch square pans. So what I'm going to do is pour my mixture in, and if it looks like it's getting pretty close to the top, then I don't want to risk it rising up and going over. So I'll just save back some of the batter and have a little cupcake for Carter. But he's not going to be able to count on that because I think I can probably fit it all in without it being any problem. I have done this kind of thing before. So we'll just pour that in. And there we go. And we'll just spread this out a little bit. You might want to pull a little from the center toward the edges to avoid having it mound up in the center. So if it starts out a little higher on the sides and then it wants to mount up in the center, they will just even out. This goes to a 350 degree oven. It's going to take about a half hour. It could be even 35 to 40 minutes, but I'll be there with my toothpick and we'll check it. And if the toothpick comes out clean, it's done. So this is going to the center of the oven, 350 degrees. Here's our gingerbread straight from the oven. It smells so wonderful. It fills the whole kitchen. I think it's really going to be great. It's hot as can be right now, so I have it on a mat. And I'm going to leave it in this baking pan for a few minutes, and then I will transfer it over to a cooling rack. And it can be cooled completely and served, but I really like it when it's a little bit warm. So I'll be coming back when it's still warm and cutting at least one piece and showing you my reaction to it. I've let the gingerbread cool just a little bit, and you can see I have cut out one piece. The rest of it's cooling, but this is still very warm. But since I like it that way, I'm going to go ahead and put a dollop of sweetened whipped cream on the top. That's the way you usually see gingerbread served. And this will just kind of drizzle down because the gingerbread is so warm. I'm just going to take a little bite from the corner here. And I'm going to get some of that sweetened whipped cream because it's going to actually melt on me pretty soon because this is so hot. That won't happen if you cool this and even refrigerate it. But you can make your own sweetened whipped cream if you like to. I have a quick tip for that. Let's see what it tastes like. It's been a long time since I've made this. I almost forget how good it is. That is so delicious. Gotta take one more piece, Rick. Sorry. And this is the best time when it's this warm and I have my cup of Earl Grey green tea ready to go. So I'm all set. How about you, Rick?
Well, I'm stuck with the camera work.
Well, it's over now. So I hope everyone enjoys this recipe. Try to remind you of what it looked like before I bit into it. Hope you enjoy it.